Now that we understand how devices can be managed one at a time, let's see how to manage devices in bulk. This task centers around a management spreadsheet, so before we get into the I/O device manager, let's see how this spreadsheet is populated. The spreadsheet has a very specific format, so rather than build it from scratch, I'll open my project folder in Explorer, navigate up to the version folder, and then down into examples. Here I have two example spreadsheets, example-all.csv and example-modbus-tcp-redundant.csv. I'll start with one of these, which is something to note. There is no function to export this spreadsheet from an existing project. If you come to an existing project where the devices were added one at a time, you'll have to build the spreadsheet on your own from an example. I find example all to be more useful, so I'll copy it into my project folder. And give it a useful name. While it's not necessary, I highly recommend keeping the spreadsheet in your project folder so it's backed up with the project. Inside the file, I have a number of examples that I'll use to base my new devices on. To start, I'll add a couple of blank rows after the header. The first column is the name of the profile for my device. This field must exactly match the name in Profile Editor, so you may want to have that open while you fill this out. The most common error I have is mistyping this field, so make sure your spaces and underscores match. I'll start with a PM8000 standard profile. Next, the name and equip columns are the I/O device name and equipment name that we used in the wizard, so I'll fill them out as before. In between is the cluster name. We'll discuss the cluster more elsewhere, but for now, just know that the cluster comes from the topology, edit, clusters tab in Studio. If you started with a blank project, it will be C1. Similarly, the primary I/O server was added with the default starter project. We'll discuss load balancing and redundancy later, so I'll just add the default I/O server 1. This is also found under Edit I/O servers in Studio. Comms method is the communication protocol used by the device and must be exactly one of these strings. This column is actually why I started with this example spreadsheet. I can just copy and paste the values as needed. Primary IP address and primary equipment address are my Ethernet and serial addresses, respectively. Since my Ion device communicates over Ethernet, I can skip the equipment address, but note that Modbus TCP devices still require that serial address. If you don't know what it is for them, you can use 255. If I want to change my port name, I can fill out primary port name, or I can leave it blank to be filled out automatically, which is my preference. As I said, we'll discuss redundancy at a later date, and most of the rest of the fields are driver-specific, like the sub-profiles are used by composite devices, primary port number is used by serial ion devices, and this entire block is used by IEC 61850. We'll talk about them when we discuss their drivers in detail. This is the general format of the I/O Device Manager spreadsheet. I'll finish filling mine out, delete the example rows, and in the next video, we'll discuss how this is used. Until then, thank you.